Episode 17 of Bleach, Heart of the Wolf, is what we're going to be getting this week in this week's episode of the spoilers. And of course, this is going to be probably a very controversial episode, believe it or not. And this is going to be primarily around, if you haven't seen the PV, CGI. So stick around as we discuss about what's happening in this episode, a quick little summary, the pictures, and where I think this episode is going to go. So if you like these videos, please hit that like and subscribe, and let's just genuinely get into it, shall we? Now, before we get into the screenshots and what I think about this episode overall, let's get into the really bad translated summary that I'm going to give you. With the captains having regained their bankai, the situation seems to be reversed. However, the Sternritter, who had released their power of the Quincy Volstandig, further pushed the Shinigami to the brink. Shinji Hiraku, who was fighting with the power of reverse to gain the upper hand, was bombarded by Bambietta and falls. But then, the armor-clad figure of Komamura Sajin returns. Meanwhile, Hoshwald, who had been quietly facing Kyoraku, moves to break the war situation, but praises Issei Nanao's technique for accurately blocking his attack. And that's pretty much the start of the episode, as these spoilers usually go around. However, I would like to say within these images that we do get, of course, usually showing the start of the episode, I will note that we actually get a Ichigo picture. Now, if you guys don't know, in the manga, at this point in time, Ichigo should be, at this point, going towards the Soul Society from the Soul Palace. However, as we all know, this scene or this scenario then has been changed and will be pushed further on in the episodes later to come. So, the interesting thing here is that we actually get an Ichigo image of him in the pathway to the Soul King, if that's what we're going to call it, or the Isoran Sando, as Ichibei calls it. It seems to me that instead of Ichigo going down from the Soul Palace to the Soul Society, it seems that this is going to be replaced with further training of Ichigo, probably at the start of the episode this time. That is my prediction on this so far. We're then, of course, going to get some Bambietta and Shinji, depending on how long this is going to go, who knows, and then, of course, we're going to get Sergeant Komamura versus Bambietta, and everybody is excited for this because of basically how it all ends. And without spoiling too much, because obviously you'll only have to wait a few days until you get to see for yourself, the question on people's mind is, how is the CG going to look? Because people either are going to love it or people are going to hate it regardless. The only studio that really does CG well is arguably Ufotable, with maybe Wit as maybe some of the exception to that. But I'm very excited nonetheless to see how this is going to look and how it's going to move. Preferably, I always want it drawn, but from going from the trailer, it doesn't look too bad, and I'm very interested or intrigued to see how this is going to play out. I expect a lot of explosions, I expect a lot of cool CG effects in general, and of course, anything with Bambietta in is going to be great and exciting. However, this is probably going to be, from here on out anyway, episodes of where I'm not going to like because of Bambietta's potential future, is what I'll say. If you know, you know. That being said, we also get to talk about Hoshwald a little bit, and that goes to talk about the barrier that Issei Nanao also puts up. I feel like we'll get a smidgen of that, and I feel like the rest of the episode from that point on is going to be in regards to Master Masculine versus some well-known captains that some of you may or may not like. Of course, I hope that this kind of gets added on or extended, and I believe if the manga does me correctly, this is potentially where we get to see some individuals from the Soul Palace actually turn up, and that's going to be exciting because we are approaching a very exciting scene, to say the least. So I'm very excited to see where that's going to go. Probably around about episode 19 is where I expect this scene to happen, but if you know, you know, and it's going to be very exciting nonetheless. This episode so far has a really good cast of animators, mainly Digimon, I believe. Two of them have already been on the Thousand Year Blood War already, which they did amazing jobs, and one of them hasn't. So I believe that they worked on some good episodes of Boruto, but other than Boruto, they have a good amount of shows under their belt. Needless to say, this is one of those episodes that is going to be very anticipated and people are going to be very much on the lookout for, so I expect this episode to have a bit of attention to detail to it. I would imagine the studio probably knows that this is going to be a very looked on episode, so I hope nothing but the best for this, considering the CG. So maybe there's a little bit of copium, but I'm hoping the animators have a bit more time to do the 2D scenes, considering the majority is going to be 3D, especially on the first half. So I'm hoping for a little bit more flexibility. But considering the images that we've got, the only thing that I am interested in is Ichigo. And I wonder how long this Ichigo thing is going to go on for, to be honest with you, considering like the space that we're going at or the pace we're going at with Ichigo at the moment. I would imagine maybe another 3 episodes and still we start seeing the climax of it. potentially. And then that's when we'll start moving from Ichigo, going from the Soul Palace to the Soul Society, which I think probably makes sense. And I think personally it fits as well. Obviously with Master Masculine as well, I'm really hoping that we get some more 3v1s with Master Masculine, get some extra screen time with Shuhei, Ikkaku, Yamashika before some captains come in and help them out. And then yeah, that sets us up for a really good episode for episode 18, which will be primarily Master Masculine, I believe, from what I've seen anyway. So which has only been a few teases here and there. So that's kind of where the direction I'm going with this episode. Other than that, it seems to be following the structure pretty well, with some additional scenes being added on instead of the Ichigo one in the manga. So pretty cut and dry. I haven't really got much more to say to that. If you want to go see what happens, you can always go check the manga. But other than that, I'm really excited. Again, I'm preparing for that CGI, but I'm hoping that the trailer did it justice, and if anything, I'm really excited to see what people's reactions who are anime onlys to Komamura, because like this is going to be a new side of Komamura that people haven't seen yet. So Komamura isn't really a captain that people really stan, like he just kind of exists. So to see if people switch up on his character after this episode is going to be really exciting for me to see what, you know, everybody thinks. So like there's that as well, like as a manga reader, to see what the reaction is going to be to that. So yeah man, like tell me what you guys think in the comment section down below. Nothing really much more to say than that, but yeah, it seems like some things have been moved around, and it will be a different experience for both manga and anime watchers. So yeah, I'm gonna catch you guys later anyway. You guys of course have this fine day, been handsome, and as always people, peace out.